Welcome back to Rap City. I'm Chris Thomas, and of course now it's time for you to meet the man. That's right, from this debut LP, The Devil Made Me Do It. This is Brother Paris, and hello to everybody in Rap City.
Salaam alaikum, brothers and sisters. My name is Paris, the Black Panther Hip Hop in San Francisco, California.
You call yourself the Black Panther of Hip Hop.
Yes, sir.
Can you tell us why?
Because many of the problems that existed when the Black Panthers existed in the 60s still exist today, even more so. Now that our communities are so plagued with drugs and there's an increase in instances of racial intolerance and oppression in this country.
Right.
And right now there's a lot of negative imagery associated with this particular music genre.
Right.
And that's what I chose to do, to counter all of that.
So you use the Black Panther
as a
positive.
Yes, sir. Representing a type of silent strength.
To educate young black people.
Yes, sir. That only strikes when provoked. Yes, sir.
And of course, you have your first single out, and your first video.
First single, Breakthrough Grip of Shame,
right.
Came out in April, and there's an accompanying video.
Right.
Which I might add, BET was the only outlet to play uncensored, and I thank you for that.
No, we do it all.
Yes, sir.
Right here at BET. So can you just tell us a little bit about Breaking the Grip of Shame
is a song that's about breaking the cycle of ignorance and intolerance and oppression that has plagued my people since our rude introduction into this Babylon of Babylons that we call the United States of America some 400 odd years ago. And the imagery that I use is Black Panther imagery, like I said, to counter all of that which is negative.
Right.
And you have the video, and I hope we'll be seeing it soon.
Oh, yes, we're going to check it out now.
Yes, sir.
You all ready?
Yes, sir.
All right, you're gonna
This is Break the Grip of Shame on Rap City.
That was Break the Grip of Shame, of course, on Paris's debut LP.
Yes, sir.
The Devil Made Me Do It.
Yes, sir. Also, I'd like to add, we were talking about this as the clip was airing, that BET is the only outlet to air Break the Grip of Shame in its uncensored form. And I'd like to say thank you.
We get the job.
Yes, sir, brother. Yes, sir.
Look, we'll be back with more Rap City, and of course, the Black Panther of Hip Hop, Paris, in a moment. Welcome back to Rap City, and of course, I'm Chris Thomas, and of course, this is
Paris.
That's right. And we saw his first video earlier, and of course, I want to talk to you about The Devil Made Me Do It.
Yes, sir.
Okay, I want to find out the concept behind the lyrics.
Okay, The Devil Made Me Do It is the second single off my debut album, The Devil Made Me Do It, on Tommy Boy Scarface Records. And the concept behind the lyrics is, it's basically just an interpretation of the oppression that we've experienced in this country. And The Devil Made Me Do It, the video is a visual interpretation of the lyrics of the song.
The idea, did you come up with the idea to do the video yourself?
Yes, sir.
As far as you directed and...
Co-directed.
You co-directed?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
You'd be relating to Uncle Sam. I see a lot of flashes of Uncle Sam.
Yes, sir. Uncle Sam is a figurehead in this country which is representative of the devil.
Right.
Of the oppressive regime that keeps my people down.
Right.
And to make a mockery of him in this video, that was my intent, because this government has never been the friends of black people, always kept us down. There's a plot now to destroy black people in this country. You see, with the introduction of AIDS, which is a genetically manufactured disease, which is ravishing the black communities over here and in Africa, and the introduction of crack cocaine into this country, which is also ravaging our people, and now the newly stepped up war on drugs, which is genocide, because it is direct assault on black people. Armageddon's been in effect, brother.
So you're saying that Uncle Sam represents America.
Yes, sir.
And this is, Uncle Sam is the man that pulled down black Americans.
That's a figurehead of the man.
Black.
Yes, sir.
Well, I want to talk about your record label, too.
Yes, sir.
Scarface Records
was founded by myself in 1987. There were four releases on Scarface Records, the fourth of which was my first single, Scarface Groove, which was a regional hit out in the San Francisco Bay Area where I'm from. that is part of the reason why I came to the attention of Tommy Boy Records. Also, my album was about 85% complete at the time. It was scheduled to come out on Scarface Records. And I hooked up with Tommy Boy in January of this year, and Break the Grip of Shame came out in April. And this is the new video and the new single, which shipped about a week and a half ago.
Wow, that's great.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Well, let's check out
The Devil Made Me Do It.
A warning, another cut to move on. Another beat that's so strong, hold on, and I get wicked and then some. Stir up, just the wit gets wisdom. People coming up, I'm straight low. Pro black and it ain't no joke. Coming straight from the mob that broke last time. Now I'm back with a brand new sick rhyme. So blackjack time and tempo. Revolution ain't never been simple. Following the path of my own for no, just build your brain and we'll soon make progress. Paid your dues, don't snooze or lose. They came with the master plan and got you. So know who's opposed to the dominant dark skin. Food for thought is a law for the brother man. Tempo 116.7 keeps you locked in time with the program. When I get wild, I'll pile on dope jams. Then spit on your flag and government. Cause help the black was a concept never meant. But you please, food stamps and free cheese can't be the cure for a sick disease. Just the way the devil had planned it. Raped and pillaged everyone on the planet. And give them fake gods at odds with all law. Love thy enemy and all that hoopla. Here close the words I wrote. Crack cocaine is genocide of black folk. Who in their right mind ever could have missed this? Damn right when you think seditious and I move swiftly. They can't get with me. The 666 move quick but miss me. When I came off involved in conscious. But don't ask why next time I start this. Allow me to freestyle, I feel and fill your mind up with know-how. A common sense, a defense, the next time a pig try to step to this. Listen, never let someone whoop on ya. They don't belong to the set you from ya. Can't be intrigued by the leaves of pig lead unless you don't give a f- to be free. Keep stomping on them, keep stomping. Attitude, but I ain't from Compton. I can't be f- around, I'm muffed around. I can't be held down. Check the sound and keep in tune on point on target. The revolution won't be thwarted. A setback cause my man is plain to see. Must in a white supremacy, so let the rhythm roll on when I kick this. Brother's gonna work it out with a quickness. And now you know just why a panther went crazy. The devil made me.
Muhammad. This is the message you're getting across also,
yes, sir,
to the young people.
Message to the black man in America by the Honorable Elijah Muhammad. Required reading for every black man, woman, and child in this country.
So you have another single on your LP. It's called The Hate.
The Hate That Hate Made.
Right.
Yes, sir. That makes reference to the Bensonhurst incident in New York, where a group of white youths attacked a young black man just because he was black and he was in what they said was the wrong part of town. I'm saying now it's time for all black people to collectively organize and defend themselves against this type of oppression. It's another reason why Embrace Black Panther imagery because we definitely need to collectively organize and protect ourselves.
Right.
Yes, sir.
I want to find out, why did you choose rap as a means to get across your message?
Well, when I first became in music, I loved music. When I first became involved in music in high school, R&B was dying out.
Right.
It was becoming redundant, and it just wasn't it anymore. And then rap began to come into play, and many different facets of rap began to come into play, and rap began to evolve, and that's when I became influenced by rap.
So is there any...
I'm a political, I guess you could say a political pop activist, but I don't really care for the other genres of rap, because that's not applicable to what I'm about. I'm trying to save my people, brother.
Right.
And I can't be concerned with all of that. It's a lot of madness, you know, associated with rap. I can't be, you know, put it in your butt. Oh, that's not me.
Right.
There's a comedy rap,
right,
hardcore rap, which is extremely ignorant.
So you like, and you were, we were talking earlier about censorship.
Yes, sir.
And
I don't agree with censorship, and don't get me wrong, in any way or form, but I do think that rap artists need to be responsible for what they say, for what we say, because we are role models, whether we like it or not.
So whatever the incident with the Two Live crew.
I love my brothers, but I tend to not comment on other rappers, especially in the media, because historically the media has played off of black people in the media, and when a conflict arises, they blow it out of proportion, as was the case with the Honorable Elijah Muhammad and Malcolm X. Two brothers who I tend to concentrate on the good they did, as opposed to concentrate on their differences, because it opened the opportunity up for the devil to come in and kill Brother Malcolm.
So, I mean, kill Brother Malcolm, and you have, like, a lot of singles on your LP, right?
Yes, sir.
Which is your favorite?
I love them all, sir.
You love them all, but do you have a particular favorite that you wanted to have released in the beginning?
No, actually, Break the Grip to Shame is the first one. Devil Made Me Do It is the appropriate follow-up. And right now, I'm really uncertain as to which one will be next. It'll probably be Mellow Madness.
Mellow Madness.
But all of them are applicable to the black condition.
I want to talk some more, okay?
Yes, sir.
We'll be back with more Rap City and, of course, the Black Panther of hip-hop, Paris.
That Rap City.
Welcome back to Rap City. I'm Chris Thomas, the man. Of course, this is Paris, the Black Panther of hip-hop.
Yes, sir.
And we're talking earlier about the negative things that are happening in the world. And of course, I'm going to give you the opportunity, Paris, to tell the young people out there about what's on Paris's mind and the way we can work things out and make this world a better place.
Yes, sir. Well, I would say to every young brother and sister out there that there are three basic steps that you can take to better yourself. First and foremost, you need to find God, because once you've found God, you can relate to your surroundings better and have better knowledge of everything. Then second of all, I would say have knowledge of self, so you can know God's plan and how you fit into it.
Right.
And third of all, have education, because education is the key and the backbone of everything that exists.
And you know something? I've been sitting here listening to this brother speak, and of course I've learned some things that, hey, what can I say? I'm a little older than you.
Trying to save my people.
How old are you?
22, sir.
22 years old. Yes, this brother right here is deep. So you went to college?
Yes, sir. Went to the University of California with a degree in economics, sir.
Economics?
Yes, sir.
Brother, you are deep. Look, we're going to check out some videos, and of course, I'm going to learn a little bit more from you.
Yes, sir, black man.
All right, hey, teach me.
Yes,
the man wants to know. This is Paris and his debut LP, The Devil Made Me Do It, on Tommy Boy Records and Scarface. And you were telling me earlier that something was troubling you.
Yes, sir. I've seen a recent increase in the perception of black women in this country, the negative perceptions.
Right.
And I've seen that there's a lot of disrespect for the black woman, and I wanted to comment on that. Anytime you disrespect or harm a black woman, you're harming the cornerstone of the mighty black nation in this country, you see. And black women need to be protected and respected They're nothing to be played with. The penalty is death.
So what do you think that causes the black man to disrespect the black woman?
Well, see, that's the way we've been taught in this country, when I would say. It comes from, first of all, let me say that we were the rulers of this planet.
Planet, right.
For centuries and centuries. And God made black and white, but white people made niggas.
Right.
And we act like niggas, like savages in this country. And that's why I'm here to bust that madness up, because I see a lot of things, a lot of influences in this country,
right,
that are both black and white imposed, because a lot of people are operating with ignorance on their brains, you see. And that's why I have to move away from all of that and show an alternative.
Brother, believe me, you are. And we'll be back with more Rap City. Of course, this is the Black Panther of Hip Hop, Paris. Hurry up back. Welcome back to Rap City. I'm Chris Thomas, and of course, I really enjoyed myself today with a very strong brother with a positive message, the Black Panther of Hip Hop.
Thank you for having
Paris.
Me, brother.
And of course, Pyramid Bookstore in Washington, D.C. I really enjoyed the books they have, and hey, brother.
Yes, sir.
I even learned so much from you today. I even went out and got me a book, that's right, The Message to a Black Man in America by Elijah Muhammad. I encourage all the young people out there to check this out. That's right, this is the book. Until next time, my name is Chris Thomas, and this is Paris. Peace, love, harmony. God bless.
I'm cool.
I'm ran like a rebel in 85. Cops tried to catch me, cause all of them said I beat up these other men who were bigger than me. Wasn't cause I'm black and they were W-H-I-T-E. Here I was walking down the block. I seen these stupid bikers standing by the biker shop. They seen it was me, so to make themselves feel bigger, one got bad bold pointing and called me a n***. I stuck my finger up, I said his mother, and kept stepping. His friend told his other friend, hey, Corky, let's get him. I looked to my back, to my surprise, one had a chain in his hand and the devil in his eye. I said, I'm in trouble, let me think real quick. I looked down on the ground and got this big fat brick. With no time to waste, I put the brick in my hand and hit the bike until the chain fell out of his hand. Then his friend cried, he said, Corky, are you alright? But what he didn't know was he was in for a fight. The right hit his jaw, he fell on the floor. The kid I hit with the brick before said don't hit him anymore. I put my brick down, left him on the ground. Everything was cool till the cops came around. They said you're under arrest for assault 2 and 3. I laughed at the cop, I said explain this to me. He said you hit the man with the brick and punched another in the jaw and left the scene like nothing happened. Then they called the law. I laughed in his face, I said this don't make sense. It was 2 against my black tank, this makes it self-defense. He tried to grab me, so I pushed him on the floor and ran my black tank home and locked the living room door. I did what any black kid would have did, but to the cops of Suffolk County, I'm known as a fugitive. If the cops of Suffolk County, I'm known as a fugitive. I had to go to school, I couldn't be late. If I missed another day, Miss Camp said I wouldn't graduate. I didn't go a lot, that didn't mean I didn't care. I had to come to school more often to try again next year. All that, I went to school and I tried, you know, to hide from the cops to June of 85. I get my diploma and things would be straight. By that, my graduation, cops came and tried to put me on the gate. I ran, though, with the diploma that I owned. Well, cops chasing me all the way till I got home. I got away again. Why? You know what I did? I ran my black fake home, and to them, I'm still a fugitive. I'm still a fugitive. The cops of Suffolk County, I'm still a fugitive. Went by me running from the cops. My mom looked at my dad said, son, this has got to stop. Dad gave my money, she said, son, this is for you. I went to Garden City to go get me a lawyer. I went to jail, Monday I was in jail, till Friday when you're black and you're in trouble, man, does your lawyer get paid? Then my mom told the judge, my son's a good child. Then he laughed at my mother and said, they'd take us to trial. I told my mom and dad I felt within. If we took Suffolk County to court a trial, I know I wouldn't win. So, without a doubt, like any black kid in Suffolk County, KSOLO had to cop out to 16 months in Riverhead. Instead of fighting and wildin', I I wrote my records instead. Commissary was boys. Inmates owe me COs who beat me up with shakedowns, but now those suckers know me, and I laugh at the cops who arrest me for what I did, cause I'm hooked and no longer am I a fugitive. I was a fugitive from cops in Suffolk County, known as a manifesting thoughts with my infinite styles, making sure this travels 23 million miles. The other six, I set the crucifix, because the heart of the problem is this.
Big on it, girl.
Preacher got my order, putting money in the pan for the rest of the week. Now I'm eating out of soup can. He has a home, drives a caddy to town. Has my own earth, believing that it's coming from the ground. Jeez. Slain of those who fought for what was right. Slain of those who fell victim to the fight. A drug control.
Prince Des Jour, chilling here with my man Paris, the Black Panther of hip-hop. Yo, Paris, tell me what type of mission you're on. We're here at Ballou High School, Washington, D.C. What's your mission?
Really, we're out here, myself and Brother Mad Mike, Brother Marcus Clemens, on the road, touching down in each high school and in every city that we visit, attempting to help dispel the myths and the half-truths that are being taught to our people in the traditional school system. So every time we touch down in the city, we come and try to have one-on-one correspondence with our brothers and sisters everywhere we go, and
try to help eradicate all the ills that afflict us in the traditional school system and come together in unity and try to do something for self for a change.
Well, as a rap artist, man, what do you feel like you have to contribute to the business itself or to brothers and sisters as a rap artist?
Really just to provide something other than the negativity that you see all too often, not only within rap music, but within all forms of entertainment as a whole, and really within just all forms of the media throughout the course of everyday living. So really we're just taking a positive stance on things, a position that is in opposition to the racist mindset that has afflicted us since we've been here.
Yo, right now we're going to take a look. Yo, what's up? Welcome back to Rap City. I'm Prince Days. You're chilling here with my man Paris, the Black Panther of hip-hop. Don't touch that dial. Rap City will be right back. Boom!
Brother Paris was producing a couple of acts. Brothers of mine, buddies of mine, ATC. And he was going to produce my act. My brother DR worked on it with me, and another partner, Jay, worked on it. And what happened was, instead of like us coming out, things fell apart between us, and he ended up working with me. He saw me DJing at a party. I was DJing a high school party, and we did like a little showcase, a little hip-hop, because I had some brothers in town talking about I was weak, so I had to come out and show him what was happening, you know. So I started cutting, and he liked what I was doing. And so then we hooked up after that.
Tell them why they call you Mad Mac, Mike, Black Man.
I'll tell you why they call me Mad Mike. I got that name in high school from my buddies, because like in high school I was trying to be a sick individual and I was trying to act like I was mad all the time because, you know, I was just going off the wrong information at that time. And so like I developed a personality where I was like trying to be sick all the time. And so that's why they call me Mad Mike. Yeah, kind of like Eazy-E, but see now I'm kind of like X-Clan in Public Enemy, you know what I'm saying?
Right, because who you sick against, Mad Mike?
I'm sick against anybody that's oppressing my people. That's I'm right. Sick against anybody that's not going to let my black women be that's beautiful right. As they are.
Oh, but I know you brothers wearing the color black, man. What's the purpose of it? It's a dominant color. I know definitely what's the purpose of it.
Black is a dominant color.
Show you right. Answer my own question, right? Right. Well, tell me, how did you all get discovered in the business? How did you get your first record? There's a lot of people they're probably interested in finding out who have talent, like as rap or dance and things like that. Right. You know, how can they get discovered?
Well, really, I started my own label in 1987 as a result of being rejected and dealing with a lot of the major labels that existed. And so I said, well, the hell with this. I can do it on my own, right? So I contacted Brother. We did four records, the fourth of which was our first attempt together. And while I was in college, I was recording the album, The Devil Made Me Do It. And we acquired the deal with Tommy Boy just prior to my graduation in 1990. And we had our first single, Break the Grip of Shame, a video which you just saw. The Devil Made Me Do It was the second video and single. And the third single that's about to come out is called The Hate That Hate Made. And see, as a result of the reluctance of video programmers other than yourselves now, to play my first two videos, I decided to pass on the third video. Because the title itself lets you know where I'm coming from. The Hate That Hate Made. See, it's hatred that I have as a result of hatred that we've experienced as African Americans since we were brought into this country. See, so I can't be concerned with any of the madness. I just got to come straight into the point now, since I see people are ready for that. Our people are in a receptive mode. See, so that's why I'm coming this way.
Yo, right now we're going to take a look at another video, Poor Righteous Teachers.
Holy intellect.
Boom!
But in a few minutes, you're going to hear from him.
In this world and how I'm living as a black man, striving to be somebody that can be respected. Put on the top, we're gonna get because I'm elected by the G. The O, the D, the E, the E, like Doma, R, D, Ball, when I swing.
I understand the games. 60 degrees. It's a circle, a 10% baby. I'll vote for correct them. Then I'll leave them speechless, correcting his ego. Then I'll teach him this lesson to the so-called Negroes and chosen people that need to grow up to a free level of independence. Well, let me tell you what it's all about. To make it clear, to be a prime example, and to erase the fear. Who put it in our hearts? I don't mind, but I want no part of your total destruction. Be it known, let's continue this function. While I'm in my prime, I'm letting you all know that it's about time.
Yo, what's up? We're back with my man Parrish at Ballou High School. We'll talk more with my man Parrish and check out his other hype video. Don't go anywhere, Rap City will be right back. Boom! Yo, what's up? Welcome back to Rap City. Prince Dejo in effect with my man Parrish here. Yo, tell me about any new projects, anything you're working on.
Well, let me see. We got a song out that's going to be coming out called Time for Peace that is our stance in opposition to this war that's going on. You know, a disproportionate amount of African Americans are over there dying for a sick country and a sick society that has never cared for us. And it's called Time for Peace. It was done with myself, brothers from Digital Underground, these new brothers that's on Giant, Warner Brothers, called MC Sway and King Tech. That should be coming out, I believe, on Tommy Boy sometime soon. Also, we're in Washington right now at a conference at Howard, a hip-hop convention, with brothers from Public Enemy, Kumo D, Sister Queen Latifah, Sister Soulja, Brother Daddy-O, Chubb Rock, a whole long list of people. And yesterday, we all made the commitment to come together and do an anti-war song as well. So there's going to be something coming out. Another hip-hop coalition along the lines of Stop the Violence Movement. The Time for Peace song, I'm going to kick a little lugs to you like this. It goes like this. Taking a stand that's firm. P-Dog is finna get warm and blow the whistle on the devil, cause devils wanna kill us all. So hear the plea and please heed the final call. And sweat as a black silhouette came forth to spark war in minds of young brains. And F the peace when police are beating down anybody close to dark shades of brown. And like I said, the devil made me break the grip of shame, cause I'm pained and I'm made to be thinking of a master plan to help save the original Asiatic earthborn man slave. Make way for P-Dog, the bush killer, cop killer, black urban gorilla, because without justice I'll bust until it's released. And only then is the time for peace. This is my new video, my old video, my video, the devil made me do it on Rap City.
Yo, yo, yo. Until next time, this Prince Dejo wishing you...
Black men.
Public Enemy rebel base, deep London. Where's Public Enemy?
Public Enemy was driven into the underground by government forces. However, a small resistance is forming. Both Terminator X and Chuck T have resurfaced, leading a small mobile rebel unit, the Valley of the Jeep Beats. Chuck D is on his way to a closed-door press conference. Terminator X will be tapping into the government-controlled feed and decoding the message to all Public Enemy rebel bases. We are at war!
Come on!
Black man, where is your heart?
Come on!
The black man is so dopey, you know the reason we can't win? Everybody's gonna have to
come
get
on.
Serious!
I try to teach to reach, I drop balls with a little flow. Remember back when I say yo, if you can't get, I don't say get up. As the world turns, so sucker learns, as one quit, another hit, ain't just a trip. That's what I'm known and thrown upon a microphone. But they try, they hang me dry, but then it's do or die. When they don't give you a reason why, they be pointing, forgetting, finger pointing at us. Damn! Should we be tearing up the joint if there was a music to use for the flexical styling? Terminator X, Buck Wildin'!
What is the matter with the black man?
there with Farrakhan. Yes, and seconds ticks for through a time bomb. Blowing up, they hope we shut up. What up? Is it shaking up, baking enough? God damn, like a gentleman stands a man with an attitude. Some people call me rude, and when they kick out, the bass in trouble. The bass in trouble. The population double. A trigger panic, the spot. The heat is on and it's hot. Life flick, Terminator gets a go. Fuck violence.
Contradicting yourself.
Come on.
Not just black or white.
Up get your gold, buck wild and damn. What the others say? The man listens, stop missing. What the brothers say? Go for book, we smoke, we go loco. Cause what I'm saying, it playing before a joke. So my tolerance, the time to fence. And what is cold, and it's cold, and it's gold. You won't find this jam on the planet, cause they take it for granted. At the end of the day, they get paid. Now there's time to rhyme. It's riding on the flex, the Terminator X. That's why I never can stop, and I won't, I don't stop. Keep the flow, the info, to the brain pop. And if you put in the sand and the look, you get there to stop piling. Terminator X, fuck wildin'.
This is Public Enemy Rebel Base D, Detroit. Yes, we copy.
If the truth hurts, then you'll be insane. If the truth drives you crazy, you'll be insane. The laws are sound, but the black man and the collective cannot get paid. As I told you before, we're in war.
Down. I see Big Daddy on a rhythm now. I go step to two and I bet ya. With the two live crew and we'll get ya. Even got to mix a lot. MC Light, that's right. She can win a run fight. We'll build a floor with incredible feet. Terminator X, Valley of the Chief Beast. I'm giving you while you're getting a little taste of the P.E. That's what it be. It doesn't matter, the planet still turns. Every second with a record so hot that the floor burns. Terminator, fuck Wally.
You can't declare war on the black man without declaring war on me. I'm a soldier and I'm out of here. 5,000.
African mythology. The myth told of the sun being named Osiris and the moon called Isis. And then there was an eclipse. This moment brought forth the birth. Due to the original's state of mind in this space and time, we who write the know summons the goddess Isis. The struggle continues. By the way, peace. This is the Professor X, the Overseer. As I glide and reside in the hutch of this meteor, seeking the goddess Isis, preparing myself to step to you in blackness. The mission, the crossroad. If you dare.
A touch of love towards the black. A load and a habit set on my back. I was self, though not alone, vainglorious. From African bone, the relationship between heart and mind. Flow from my mouth, but in your mind not defined. See the connection, remember the lesson. The lady of thunder, so my aggression. Let the bass be on and on. Beating while I'm lightning, the word is born. Stand up, hail to the queen. Cause if you think this is dope, then I'm a dope fiend. A black radical, ride the rhythm, I'm a rebel. On a positive level. So feel the vibes of my madness. Here's a touch of love from pure blackness. From which I was made, where camel stole the sand and pyramids lay, where my people cry and laugh along with us, the motherland, one almighty Africa. That which is said shall be remembered. Power to the people who have never surrendered. This is the memory of yesterday, the meaning that enhances my strength in one glorious way. I'm making sure infinity is ours again. We have no bounds, no limits, and no end. Welcome all, word into my kingdom. Come to witness the light of my wisdom. Beat, beat, beat. The power of myself is moving my heart, my birth for what it's worth. I'm coming to existence with persistence, with no indifference, with no assistance. I am myself coming forth.
inner light, a renaissance, a rebirth. May I sing and flow to my destiny? A touch of love and you haven't heard the best of me. Mess with mentality, a mere technicality. You are drowning in the stream of a knowing. We are on boat afloat, warm with the wind of the real. The truth unveiled, the wrath of the actual set of sail. Even the path of life can be walked with precision, but only the black watches the path of existence.
Yellow blackness to the crossroad, if you dare. Van Glorious, this is protected by the red, the black, and the green with a key.
Name of ISIS. Next to her, without a doubt, truly a committed individual to the freedom of our people, we have Queen Mother Rage. On the other side of her is Paradise the Architect. He is the practitioner. He is the brother that has been with me many years trying to pull together a move that would be as clear as the Black Watch movement, who's not here, and by way of this side of the world, you know, this is definitely not our natural habitat. We have a bunch of colds running around the Black Watch movement. The flu hit the grand verbalizer funkin' lesson brother Jay. We like to say peace to another brother who has committed his life to the freedom of black people, and also Sugar Shaft, the rhythm provider.
Okay. Let's first break it down. The Black Watch movement itself, what does it stand for? What direction is, and how did it get started?
Well, it happened some years back when a young man by the name of Yusuf Hawkins was brutally slain on the street for him just simply being the color he was, noted being made that he was in the wrong neighborhood. After viewing this fiasco across the media, it was like the bottom line, the last straw, so to speak.
Mm-hmm.
So a few of us, a few young people, decided that we had to mesh talent with the design of bringing young people together to unite against these kind of atrocities happening any further. So, no, it didn't start by way of the interest of entertainment. More so, it started by the way of a young brother who gave his life, who we consider a hero, by way of us just coming together and deciding that we were going to commit ourselves to freedom of death and do something about the original's existence.
Freedom or death, you brought that up.
Yes.
I've heard, what does freedom or death stand for as far as when the members of Black Watch say freedom or death?
Well, like nothing like those who will find their virtues tested being in the presence of us, nothing by way of their meaning of just following a one individual or following a cultish idea. Freedom of death means that, do you understand that young black people are in trouble? Do you understand to the degree that we must do something about the troubles that will be upon us the next generation? Do you understand that the only way that we're going to understand the seriousness of this existence is that the only way you're going to get there is being prepared, like the Egyptian, preparing himself for the other side, that we get that out of the way, knowing that it takes to that point to do whatever we have to do to stop young black people from being killed on many levels. may it be mental, may it be emotional, may it be physical. And we are being killed on all those levels.
Okay, I understand that. I'll tell you what. Let's roll to the first video by X-Clan to give you an idea of what they're talking about. We'll come back and we'll talk to ISIS, Queen Mother Lady.
That's definitely the word that I know a lot of people would really like to get clear understanding. First, I'll let you know what leads us to a creation of a word like this. Something like this word. What's the word?
Zoom.
What's the word?
Zoom.
Word.
Zoom.
Word.
Zoom.
Word.
Zoom.
Word.
Zoom. Zoom. Zoom.
Zoom. Zoom. Zoom. This is a Zulu tradition. This word means war. This word is also looked upon as being a blessing of strength when the native is at wartime, when the black existence is at threat in the motherland once upon a time. We have rehashed that word, as well as creating a word, the word vainglorious. You see, we recognize that the black existence in America or in Britain, that we've never really had a true respect of the king's language. I say this, it has been so effective or so much of a realization of our not great respect for it that we've sent professors, you know, like in Howard University, board education systems all around the country. We've, because of this this doing, we've sent them back to school to learn the English that we feel comfortable with, that comes within our environment. So we decided that in praise of the understanding that the king's language really is not something that, you know, that keeps us up at night, we created a word. The word was vainglorious. This word means ours. It means black, a music that shall not be labeled, for instance, R&B, rap, etc. We do that in that movement to say that when you hear the word vainglorious, you know, when you see this face and the word protection and vainglorious, that what you're about to see is product or inspiration from this style of approach in the music. We also want to say that, Mr. Webster, thank you, but no thank you. We'll create our own.
Words of Professor X and the Black Watch Movement. And we'll be right back with more Rap City in a moment. Hey, you're learning a lot today. Stay tuned.
Get my message across. My record can go overseas out of the country. So I became black conscious. And my first conscious song was called A Black Thing. After that, my writings became more deeper into black consciousness. So basically, he's helped me up the steps of the pyramid.
Your album is out right now. It's Rebel Soul, and the first single is?
Rebel Soul.
Exactly. What are you talking about in within Rebel Soul?
Rebel Soul, to me, is self-explanatory. Basically, it's my soul is a rebel. Me, X-Clan, Queen Mother Rage, and PX, we're on the same path. We just have different viewpoints. Basically, the same message is there for young people to take destiny into their own hands.
Simple enough, I understand. Why don't you pitch your video so we can see what you're talking about? And a little bit later on, we're going to be slipping into darkness, Queen Mother Rage, but kick to your video.
This is Rebel Soul on Rap City. Peace.
Grand Verbalizer, what time is it?
Right, chill.
What's the word?
Zoom.
What's the word?
Zoom.
Peace. We are the sisters of Black Watch, continuing to strengthen black women, coming forth with a rebel step, with rebel soul. With an Asada lick. Overseer?
Once again, a messenger group steps to you in blackness. The name ISIS. The struggle continues. By the way.
For you, I light fire in the sky. My love dispels darkness. I place the pot over fire, add water, flour, and meat. We shall nourish each other with worms and bread. Born of stars, of pale moonlight skimming mountaintops. We are men and women exchanging glances at the crossroads. I am born of the sky.
Boy, knowledge of a slave's foot.
own. Rebel soul, the truth is not known. The battle cry for freedom, shout aloud, and again sweat drops from the black crowd. The scroll is the magic, I am the bearer. The wisdom's in my words, my mind is your mirror. Let the war drum unroll. Stand brave and witness rebel soul.
Now onto the road, traveling dark space in a black watch mode. The key brings you the dazzling mother load. No justice, no peace. Handing back the planet's just the least. Too many sins left for the other side. Now there's spirit seeking the freedom ride. We have come.
The threat to the birth of a clan. Forget the ego. It takes a woman and a man. My guard is up, so now you cop a plea. This is protected with a key, you sissy. From black watch, rises minds of magic. Tamper with that, the result, tragic. That glorious knowledge on the tip of my tongue. Equipped as all true rebels come. A force like an obstacle from the path. The spirit, the signs to my man. The method is confined. The simple business secrets in the life of mine. Destined to the road, the path, the journey. You witness the flame, but it cannot burn me. Step by step, a higher level of a pyramid. Strike down, you're worthless and valid. I am the hand on the face of your clock. Only the mind of the weak keep tripping on the same rock. Rebel soul from the heart.
Here's the thought of a 12-gauge. Let me turn this black page. Day one, the tale of the original sun. In a stolen land smacked by logic. Comes the understanding of the black man. So let's be me, bearing a crown with a key, stepping to the possibilities of we. Yo, B, can't you see? Only by all means for me, and freedom or death go we.
Rebel soul, the key is the goal. Profess, profess, the act of black turns bold. Let the oppression come again. Attitude's a lesson I can defend. I create a rule for what it's worth. Please listen, my fist bears wounds, but then the upright. Like a scribe, I come. The black watch the distance, the moon to the sun. Rebel soul has just begun.
At the road, vanglorious. This is protected by the red, the black, and the green. With a key, city.
We're back with more Rap City. Paradise.
Peace.
I'd like to ask you about one image in the Black Watch movement, the flag, in which they show a symbol which resembles Professor X, but it's not. Could you explain?
Oh, yeah. You know, a lot of people have been asking us a question about that. And the symbol on the flag, the most significant thing about the symbol is that he's on one knee. There's a lot of science behind the reason why he's on one knee. And I think people should get into why he's on one knee more than the resemblance, because that the symbol itself was the first brother. And it was an image that we had. Only by coincidence did our crowns evolve in the way that they have. And if you ask me, I think it's a great representation that that brother on the symbol is a little bit of all of us. And we should, you know, look up to it like that. But, you know, people always want to make things what they will, but that is the first brother and the evolution of the Black Watch movement.
And check, can you check the mind trap? Do you see how easy it is for us to be distracted away from the real truth? You see, someone takes the form of a crown. It's not even my nose. I got a big nose. You can't even tell that on that flag. So, you know, that's a little kidding on the side. But the seriousness is that the shape of a crown can have individuals having a problem with understanding the knee. Why would a man be on his knee would be the most important thing, I would think, if it would be about opposing a question to the representation of that symbol. Why is he on a knee? I think that knee is going to explain why a person would have a problem with the crown first. Because a knee means humble.
And before the crown.
Huh?
Before the crown.
Yes, the knee means humble. And one of the problems black young people have today is that they've avoided the virtue, how to humble themselves. So the knee is actually saying,
when we look at the idea that one can get distracted by the shape of a crown, the knee is actually saying one of the major problems, it keeps us from being who we are, or keeps us from being where we think we should be.
And we'll be right back with more Rhapsody in a moment, so stay tuned. The crown, the beads, the staffs. Some say gimmick, you say?
I say be careful of the war against the mind state. I say that gimmick is a state-of-the-art way of saying the hood is chastising you, boy, girl. I say that it is natural. It is disappointing when I realize how far away we are from our descending histories. When I say that, I mean to say that back in the natural habitat, there was a young boy turned 13, and this young boy was sent out of his house into the woods or into the jungle with a spear. He could not get out of it. He could not wait another day or another year because of the love and the spoiledness to set in. At 13, he had to go. So he went off into the jungle with this spear. He had to bring back a lion's tooth. Now this lion's tooth was very important. It was the transition between boy and man and the kind of man he would be if he came back with the tooth. So this young man probably went out in the jungle, ran into a lion and dropped his spear. Couldn't run as far as he thought he could and stumbled across a branch or a stick from a tree that might symbol or look like a staff. And he found himself beating this lion and getting his tooth with the staff. He brought his tooth back, and he brought that stick back. The reason why I brought that stick back, because it reminds him of how he had to come with a new weapon that was unlike the one he was sent out. So the staff represents virtue, and how well when you were at that point of meeting or seeing virtue in the eye, how well you were going to handle it. The beads are as such. The beads always represented, these trinkets represented gifts of virtue. My beads were given to me by someone I love. So I wear them as beads of love. I wear them and I touch them when I feel down and depressed. So for those who want to go for the gimmick, I want you to know we are at war. And it don't necessarily mean it's a physical one.
Understand that. One other thing, the pink Cadillac. The pink Cadillac, what you're driving?
Yes.
Why a pink Cadillac?
Let me show you. Let me give you another little quick story. Just a quick one. Malcolm X came back from Mecca with some understandings that he never understood before he got there. And when he came back, he was emotionally disturbed because he started to see other visions of who he was and where he was going. Well, in this point or that moment in turmoil of consciousness, there was a community that also existed around his mosque. And these were young black people who were part of the street. These black folk did not choose to be part of the street. Like any African, he had to be creative to survive. And one of those individuals might have had a pink caddy because of the nature of the street. So I say, not only hail homage to Detroit Red, Malcolm X, I say hail homage to the brother that had to run the number hole to send his son to college. He drove a pink caddy. This one was a 59.
Tell you what, we go to a funkin' lesson right now.
Yes.
And Queen Mother?
Yes, sir.
What are we going to go into after that?
We're going to relax, but not on our mentals. And we're going to go to slipping into darkness.
Right here on Rhapsody.
In the Black Watch movement, once again, a messenger of such, her name, Queen Mother Rage. We flow with the zero.
3 years, 1889 through 1921, 3,436 blacks lynched. The mission, the anti-lynching bill, the revelous Ida B. Wells. The struggle continues.
What I elicit is a flow intruding, but smooth I diffuse their egos, relax. But not of your mentals. Heed the message I relate if it offends you. I deduce that you're rude in defense of your ignorance. And there's no use for it since I live to dismiss the context of the idol incompetent. Inside the cavern is unconscious, awakened black conquest, evident dominance. We are the originals. For us to take a stand and see this critical. Rules are forbidden. Their mission is to stop this. And you assist them for a profit. Truth of their fortune should be light within the prism of your wisdom. But they explain and you forgive them. A victim to the gift they've gathered. They withhold you from the motherland. Misled that money makes a better man. Discipline's the foundation to manhood and knowledge. It's time you come from the promise that we come to take back all it is ours. And it's an imposition when you shun a lack power since already you possess heart and magnitude. But you let them oppress you with inaccurate views of your African descendancy. So if you don't look for the light on the path, you'll forever be. On the edge of darkness, you can't move. Budge or nudge and the hell I call will consume. But I'ma throw you a line, don't be afraid of a light. I'll try to pull you in if you don't fight. The charismatic orator came to relate to you. A message that could save your life like a lifesaver. Do grab hold, don't allow yourself to be swallowed. Or down we both will go. The main ingredient for fear is the unknown. When intimidated, stimulation sedates the soul. A temple itself should bring about a abundance is a pleasure. Instead, you neglect it with elixir. Submission to drugs is a corruption amongst us. Just another brother or sister or self-destruct. Not for me, for the kings and queens they were to be. I pray, perhaps a leader, now a slave. But I don't live to die in vain without an outcome. Drugs are the insurrection. So why be controlled by a controlled substance? I hold the peace that you seek, not the contraband. That's the key to it all. If we connect, you're protected. Then glory is selected. If you let me be for thee, receive the positive vibe. I don't slack, but the pieces do not fade to black.
The year 1989, Yusef Hawkins lynched. The mission, Black Watch. The revelous Queen Mother Rage. Freedom or death. By the way, Vainglorious, this is protected by the red, the black, and the green, with a key, sissy.
We're back after Slipping in the Darkness and Queen, Mother Rage. That was all you in the last one. How did you get involved with the Black Watch movement?
Long story. For your sake, I'm going to make it short. Went a few paths, tried a few things, did not work on an ego trip like my sister because that was the way to get paid, so said. Not very interested, so I always had something to say, very conscious, so I felt it needed a little bit of development, so my brother Sugar Shaft brought me onto this path of Black Watch. Here I developed into another kind of lyricist. I like to talk. I have a lot to say, so that's how it was done.
Okay. The concept of Slipping into Darkness, was it yours?
Of course. All of our concepts are our own. We may feed off of each other's vibes and inspirations and suggestions, but our lyrics are our own. We have our own minds. We have our own viewpoints. Like the sister Isis said, we all speak on different viewpoints. Nobody's style is the same. Nobody speaks the same.
But the message is the same, of course, to uplift the race and how many different ways we can do that.
Zoo. One tree, different fruits on the one tree, right? Well,
of course.
One tree, different branches, and then we sprout the fruits, I like to say.
Okay. And when I say congratulations, you were the proud, true
Queen Mother. Mother became a mother. Mm-hmm. As my sister Isis is a mother also, this is not common knowledge, but let it be known. That makes us twice as beautiful.
I'll tell you what, we'll be right back with more Rhapsody in a moment, so stay tuned. We're back after that break, and Professor X.
Peace.
Two more members of Black Watch have joined us.
The Black Watch movement. We are talking about the base of what makes everything work. The base that gives the influence to those who come in front of cameras and put it on wax. These brothers that you see sitting in back of you are brothers that on the struggle tip, the everyday struggle tip in New York, take part in many rallies day by day, show up at many courts to express, you know, the anger of how we are treated in that court system. The very brothers who find themselves policing the neighborhood or running up against crack houses, deaf to the crack dealer. These brothers of those that live this. You see, this is why we stress freedom or death, because there's more than the wax. There's more than the glitter. Our mission is to present what we do or what these brothers do, to present it to you, to bring you onto the streets, for you to see the realities that are out there, for you to see the kind of war that we are in. Again, I say to you, it ain't all the time a physical one. The chains don't necessarily have to be on your wrists. It can have something to do with your mind state. So I say peace, and I say, what's the word?
Zoom.
What's the word?
Zoom.
What's the word?
Zoom.
And a few people didn't notice, I also am a member of Black Watch.
Yes.
And tell the people, as every time you throw a concert, you have a performance.
Yes.
You have a membership rally.
Yes.
At the end of your concert. Yes. How can one, and if I may say this, it's open to anybody.
I'd like to kind of make it very clear that our movement is about young black people getting things done. I'm saying it is now time to take care of home. I'm saying, once upon a time, there was a movement called the Weathermen. I don't wanna tell you the history, because you see, the next thing about how we like to drop a lesson, other than telling you what the lesson is that we like you to find it out on your own. It's much more interesting. But I gotta give you a little bit, because I want you to understand that if there's a person out there that is of another complexion, that understands that we are not trying to appease them or those because of their color, because if that's what you think it is, then you have a problem. I say to you that membership has to do with you understanding that if you're going to be my friend of another color and you want to be a member, this is a black thing. This is a real black thing. We're taking care of home first. Before we start considering all the things that you will attack us with, you know, like Semitism, anti, or racists, or whatever you choose, all we're trying to tell you is it's time for young people to say, let's take care of home. So those of you who want to come along and take the ride, proving yourself, of course, understand the need and the realness of that. If not, whatever you feel is your business, we're taking care of home.
True words spoken by the brother, Professor X. Yes, thank you.
Thank you. Hey, it's an honor. It's an honor to have a brother. See, I get a chance to talk to this brother outside of the cameras and stuff. And, you know, this is not a popularity contest here. This brother is very, very true to heart and how he feels and what he does. And he's so true to heart that he has to be whatever you have to be to keep it going, for you to see that it's time for us to do something. So understand how hard sometimes it may be while he sits in that chair.
trying to be what he has to be for you, to at least get a vision of something like us, or a Paris, or a P.E., or a Boogie Down production. I say hail and homage to the brother. Peace, brother.
Peace.
Years of the Nine.
Years of the Nine.
On the black hand side.
And like I always say, until all are one, fade to black. We're out of here.
Okay, I only have time for one more question.
Excuse me, sir, David Duke, from the WAB, Whites Against Blacks. I noticed that you've taken a lot of flack for your smash hit, Roll It Up My Homeboy. And you must admit that it was rather a controversial song. What do you have to say about that?
Success and effect is a controversial group without a doubt. We don't deny that fact. But what we're trying to do is speak out for the 22 million masses of black people that have been affected from 400 years of oppression and depression. We're doing this effectively through the tool of hip-hop. The point that we're trying to stress is that unity is going to be the key to our success.
We must band together, fight together, forever never come on the negative tip. Yo, you're jocking. Many of your blacks fall prey to this lifestyle. I don't walk that way because I'm wild. Government want us to fight and never unite. But tell me which one is right. Black on black crime, how can we stop this? Simple. Infiltrate the white supremacists, give them back their fame. Yo, we know the game, we ain't pushing no one cane. It's time to stop and react, stop acting whack. And finally put your color on the map, which is black. You said that's just a thing of the past, my brother. See, you love the white man's trash. If the blacks had a place to eat, tell me, would you eat? Would you grovel at the white man's feet? I noticed some say that the John with the movement will prove it.
Also, in line with this economic philosophy of black nationalism, in order for us to control the economy of our own community, we have to learn the importance of spending our money in the community where we live.
Racism, pounding on the door of another man. Give a damn if he's age up, please cut the pan. He still stands on his own two feet. Doesn't make him obsolete, cause colors only can be bonded. Holding to the old ways of what you've been taught. A brother is no good unless he breathes on the board. I even heard some say killing niggas is a sport. Racism must die and there's no need for remorse. Just like a baby wanting child support. Fighting all the way for some money in a court. Father goes to jail, oh well, there's no bail. Mother works hard, children think daddy's well. Mother works to die and the cycle repeats. Child support, a mere form of the street. If we choose to fight, we can handle this. No strange cause and effect, we can handle this. While the second turns, we describe the improvement. Read the blueprint.
But when we shift it to the level of human rights, we have the support of billions of black, brown, red, and yellow people from all over this earth behind us.
Some of them forget where they come from and they never look back. Never trying to help another, and to me that's whack. Even hustlers on the street give money to kids. Or are you too concerned with your ride, with your live? No one's ever tried to tell you you're forgetting your race. Never visit your mother because of Project Space. Just remember, as a kid you never thought like that. It's the future, black man, and the past you forgot. That's the problem with the race, jealousy always kicks in. Call it anything you want, it's still the black man's friend. Never trying to help another, always trying to do better than. And so on and so on, it's the curse of the black man. Kick away the shackles, we are unit of one. Only then when we overcome, son, and be a positive race. And in case you didn't know, put your money in a black bank and watch us grow. All obstacles in a way for the movement. Read the blueprint.
And this is one of the reasons why wherever you find Negroes, a slum condition usually develops, but we have to live in the ghetto. Because all of our wealth is spent elsewhere.
I'm on a mission to get ill and show you the right deal. Speak only your silver tongue, but listen to overcome. A junior Farrakhan, speak only the truth. I spread the word like a bird through my fellow youth. This is what we got, a world full of trouble times. Don't race the time, right here's where I draw the line. How can you say that this land is trouble-free when the land that you love is being bought by the Japanese? Two and three weeks, brother, survival of my race. The touch is on and letting me go on the flow. History in the making, I'll be taking girls awaken. No time for breaking. Here's another example of a lyrical fitness. That's equipped with black on black crime, and you will understand. Here's another of an Asiatic man you'll comprehend when I transcend. Read the blueprint.
Well, it's true, just as it took nationalism to bring about freedom for our brothers and sisters in Africa and Asia, it'll take the gospel of black nationalism.
Ooh, fiery attitude claiming our boast. Smoke, sometimes sing the blues. Twain, metal, and settle. Try to never backpedal. Gonna pile some God to get a shot. You know, the border I avoid. I test the paranoid. I never had to be bad. My mama raised me mad. So what I got is hot. Love my life a lot. I'm never sad, just glad. That's why I thank my dad. Nah, I ain't with this.
But watch out, man.
I ain't with it.
They never give a fuck with me. None of my little one clock to hit. Focus.
I ain't with it.
This is what I mean, I am a machine.
Five on my back.
black just because I'm black. I can't walk in the park just because I'm dark. Boys in blue and it crew sweating me and I'm through with the crap that they pull up on the avenue. Well, they're accusing the black is gonna cost them the same crap that they pulled up there in Boston. Blaming us for a crime without them checking the time. That's why I'm down with Al, plus the F.O.I. Don't get caught in between the evil, good and the mean, cause they'll get you in their fucking anti-machine. Just the way that we were, so I just stayed in the crib until I got a buzz.